What's up, YouTube? Hot Lead Retired here. All right, guys. This is an update on the Virginia gun resistance. And the only thing really new that has come up, and I haven't made a video in a little while, but I took a break from all this internet chatter, social media chatter about all this gun stuff in Virginia because it was aggravating me, man. Felt good to take a break from it. But now the governor, I'm sure everybody knows by now, there's a new Senate bill, SB 30. It deals with the budget. And the governor is appropriating $250,000 to put in the Department of Corrections budget reserve fund, is what it is. And that money is going to be used to help house the influx of criminals that do not obey the new gun laws in 2020. So, and it says it right in the bill. I went to the website and looked at the bill. It's right in there. So that's what it's used for, to house the influx of expected criminals that are not going to follow the new gun control laws. Okay. You see, this governor, I don't know what his deal is. It's like he's threatening us every day. Every time it's like a little fight between us and him. And I know we're getting to him. All these videos on YouTube, all the stuff on social media, the sanctuary cities and in the counties. It's getting to him, guys. It's really getting to him. So I don't know how it's going to end, but I can tell you one thing. I can tell you how it feels because I'm right in the middle of it, guys. I'm right in the middle of this whole thing. I live in Virginia. And I've never seen anything like it in my whole life. And there's a lot of crazy talk from both sides. And on social media and stuff, I don't know if everybody's seen it, but where I guess I'm local, it's all over my social media stuff. And it's on YouTube and everything. It's just everywhere. But it's even on our local news. I don't know if everybody's getting it, but our local news stations every now and then will put up, you know, a little video clip about what's going on. But the AG, the Attorney General of Virginia, you know, everybody knows he said that these sanctuary cities have no legal authority whatsoever, which that's true. We knew that before he even done it. We just wanted to show the solidarity of our people in the state, and what they want is not, they don't want their guns taken away. They don't want their gun rights taken away. And we just want to fight back and show the governor that 90% of Virginia do not want their gun rights taken away. And the governor keeps saying all the polls show this. Well, this poll don't lie. This poll is real. This poll is a resolution from all these communities. And some of them's got ordinances. And it was voted on by the community in each county. And apparently 90% of them, or 90% of the counties, are now Second Amendment sanctuary counties. So you cannot dispute that. He cannot dispute that. Polls can be disputed because polls are pretty much, you can't really verify them. But this, you can verify this. You can verify this because it's going to be on every county and town and city's law books. It's going to be down in the books, and it's going to be mailed to Richmond anyway. I'm sure you get a copy of it. So those are the real polls, guys. Those polls they put on TV, the polls he's going by, you can't go by that. You can't go by it. But we'll see. We'll see. But the only thing I want to talk about today, and it's going to be, I'm trying to keep it short as I can, but the people here feel like the governor is throwing fuel on the fire with all this stuff he's coming out with. And it seems like a every other day occurrence. And he keeps poking at the hornet's nest and he's going to get stung. And I think that's what he's wanting to do. And in my opinion, everybody asks me, well, what do you think is going to happen? What do you think is going to happen? Now, guys, I gave my opinion once before, and some people, like, didn't really like it. But I watched the video on YouTube. I don't know the guy's channel. But this is how I found out about that Senate Bill 30 that I'm talking about, the funding of the Corrections Reserve Fund. Anyway, he thinks it's going to end with the money. So what he was meaning by that was the governor's going to refuse to fund all these A2 or Second Amendment sanctuary counties, pretty much. And pretty much starve everybody out, which would work if he's got the guts to do it, and he might, because he's an idiot. But I really can't see him defunding 90% of Virginia, guys. I mean, if he takes money away from the counties, you're talking about the children won't be able to go to school, the teachers won't get paid, social services won't get paid, law enforcement won't get paid. Now, that is like basically cutting your own head off if you're the governor, because this is your state and you're going to turn it into this overnight. And it's going to, and I don't know how long, if he does that, it won't last long if he does it at all. And I just don't think it's going to happen. I don't think he's going to defund. Worst case scenario, I don't know exactly what gets funded from the state and our county. But it'd be like the federal government shutting down where programs that are necessary will be funded. I don't see him shutting down schools or social services or anything like that. Or law enforcement. You got to have that, you know. So what I think is going to happen is all these laws are going to be challenged in court. Some of them get shot down as unconstitutional. Maybe most of them. Hopefully all of them. But when they pass these in January, if they pass them, they still got to vote on them. They still got to edit them. They still got to redo everything. They got to go to committee and they got to change stuff and rework it and blah, blah, blah. All right, then after they vote on it, some will get in, some won't. Maybe they all will, who knows. But they will be challenged in court. They will not take effect until July 1st of 2020. So that gives it time for all these court hearings on probably every one of them. And there's going to be injunctions. And it's going to be tied up in court for at least a year or two on some of them. And it's just going to take a while, guys. And everybody's on these YouTube videos that don't even live here, that don't even know what's going on. They don't have any skin in the game. They're setting up in their house making videos, and they probably live in who knows where, you know, thousands of miles away from here, wanting us to do something, attack the Capitol, blah, blah, militia here, militia there. Guys, it's easy for you to say if you don't have any skin in the game. Nobody here wants to get killed. Nobody here wants to get put in prison. But nobody wants to give up their guns either. You see what I'm saying? Nobody wants to register their guns. So, in the end, I can pretty much say, living here, that there's not going to be very many people register their guns. I'm thinking maybe 10%, guys. They're not going to comply. It's not going to happen. They're not going to. Bottom line is, they're not giving up your guns. Okay, whatever happens, happens. But they're not giving them up, not willingly. And I'm just saying that from what I see, what I hear, what I feel, you know, because I'm here, ground zero, if you want to call it. But never seen anything like this, guys. I'm talking everybody, women, men. Democrats, Republicans, we got all walks of life, all races, and we got people from all kinds of occupations. I mean, you got doctors, you got lawyers, you got regular folk. You got preachers. You got law enforcement. They're all here. They all own guns. They don't want to lose their gun rights. So, you know, politicians, they don't want to lose their gun rights either, locally here. So, I think what will end up happening is, if this is the worst case scenario, if, let's say all the laws pass the courts, and they're not going to comply, the law enforcement is not going to go door to door and look for your guns, they don't know where your guns are. They don't even know if you have guns. Unless you register them, that's when they will know where they are and who's got them. But law enforcement's not going to come and break down your door looking for guns that may or may not be there. They're not going to do that. The only way, and I'm talking about after the ban goes in effect and after the registration goes in effect and nobody's complying with it, the only way I see law enforcement get involved in all in any shape or form is if you get pulled over for a traffic stop. You got an AR-15 or something laying in your back seat. And since AR-15 have to be registered, I'd say they'd have the authority to check and see if it's registered in the state of Virginia. Okay? Comes back, it's not registered, I'm pretty sure you're going to get charged with it. You see what I'm saying? Or if you're out in the middle of the street with an AR-15 walking downtown, I'm pretty sure they're going to stop and check and see if it's registered or not. Okay? Or if you commit a crime somewhere and they come to your house with a warrant and they search your house and arrest you, and they, while they're searching for whatever they're charging you with, say drugs, they're looking for drugs, they find the AR-15, they're going to check and see if it's registered or not. And if it's not, you're going to get charged with that also. That's the way I see law enforcement enforcing the laws, okay? But if you're just a regular guy going to work every day, coming home, you know, obeying all the laws, I don't see any problem with that. Okay. And I think that's the way it's going to go. But I guess the worst case scenario is they try to do some stupid stuff like come in here and go house to house or whatever. And I could see some problems happening then, really. So that's it in a nutshell, guys. That's what I think is going to happen. And there's some things we got to do, and we really got to do it. And they're having some rallies, and they're having some the lobby day, and the NRA's having something on the 8th of January in Richmond, some kind of rally. We need to keep cool heads, guys. We can't go down there, or you can't go to Richmond and cause problems, especially with guns, because that's just going to give the governor a reason to say, you see, guys, this is why I want to ban these guns. They're too dangerous to bring them out here. And if anything happens, it's going to be all over the media. And by the way, guys, I heard that a lot of the hotels around Richmond is booked up by the media on January 20th. There's going to be a lot of media there. So if you go on January 20th, please, just please don't try not to cause any problems. I'm not saying let somebody beat the hell out of you. You got to defend yourself. But I'm just saying, don't let them get you into a situation, because that's what they're going to try to do. They're going to try, if there's any protesters there, which there probably will be, they're going to try to get you into an argument that will probably try to get it to lead to somebody getting assaulted. Don't do that. Just be cool. Walk away if you have to. Do something. Go. There's going to be all kinds of police there. They know the threat's there. And they're beefing up for it, and it's all being worked out as far as security goes. But by no means, don't let somebody beat the crap out of it. I mean, defend yourself if you have to, is what I'm saying. But don't unless you have to, don't. We got to be kind of civil, because the worst thing that could happen right now is to give the governor a whole bunch of news clips of gun rights activists beating down a bunch of people. You see what I'm saying? That's the worst case scenario. Because you know it's going to be all over CNN, MSNBC, and everything. Because that's what they want, guys. They want violence, blood, and guts. That's what gets them views. That's what gets their ratings up. And CNN and MSNBC both could do like a 3-day miniseries on it. And just so they can build up their ratings. We don't need that. Remember that. Guys, we really can't do anything until they do something like pass the laws. And then we can go to court. You see, it's a react. We are in a reaction mode. But because there's nothing we can do until the laws are passed and see what laws get passed. And then we can fight them in court and go from there and cross each bridge as we get to it. Now, I don't mean you got to sit on the sidelines and do absolutely nothing. Yeah, go out and support your rallies and your protests and all this stuff. Let them know how you feel. And also, start practicing for stuff, scenarios, whatever you need to do. That's your time to do it. Anyway, I just want to put this out there. If you want to, type down in the comments what you think is going to happen. I mean, I'm open for anything. Actually, it might be a learning experience for people like me. I've never been through this before. And really, none of us have here. This is our first time going through this, pretty much, guys. I mean, you know, so we got people helping us that's been through it before. Got some good organizations and all this stuff that are helping us. And we're taking the steps that need to be taken at this point. And that's all I can say. And I'm going to go ahead and live my life just like I've been living it since before all this stuff happened. I'm going to do what I do, like I do every day. I'm going to go to the range. I'm going to shoot. I'm going to go fishing this summer. I'm going to do my own thing that I always do. Until something happens where I can't. And then that's the bridges I'm talking about. We got to cross them when we get there. All right, guys. Thanks for watching Hot Liver Tired Out of Here. Thank you. Hey, guys. Thanks for all the subscribers. I can't believe this, man. I got like 120 subscribers like that. But I'm going to try to give y'all an insight. That's what I'm doing. Updates and insights as stuff happens here. Sometimes it's going to happen fast. Sometimes it's slow. You never know what's going to happen in Virginia. But keep you posted. All right. Hot Liver Tired Out of Here. Later.